Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Anna Cloren. Hi, Anna.
Good morning. The northeast monsoon is now affecting over Luzon, bringing cloudy skies with light to moderate rains over Cagayan Valley, Apayao, Kalinga, Aurora, and Quezon. While the easterlies will continue to bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over the Caraga region, eastern Visayas, Catanduanes, Albay, and Sorsogon. The rest of Mindanao, the rest of Visayas, the rest of Bicol region, and Palawan were expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we're expecting a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains, also due to the northeast monsoon. The temperature range here in Metro Manila is from 24 to 31 degrees Celsius. In Baguio City, 15 to 25 degrees. And in Tagaytay, is from 22 to 29 degrees Celsius. That's the latest from Pagasa. This is Anna Cloren Horda. Good morning.
Thanks for that update, Pagasa forecaster Anna Cloren Horda. China telling the Philippines to stop pursuing what it called the wrong course in their maritime dispute. China's foreign ministry insists Beijing will not weaken its resolve in protecting its maritime interests. China then accused the Philippines of repeatedly violating its sovereignty by spreading false news and bringing other countries into their issues.
For some time, the Philippines has been making provocations on Rinnai Reef and other issues and drawing forces outside the region into those issues. China is compelled under those circumstances to take necessary measures to firmly respond to it. That said, China's door of dialogue remains open. We are ready to work with the Philippines to properly handle maritime issues through negotiation and consultation. We hope the Philippines will step back from the brink and stop heading further down the wrong course at once.
The remarks by China's foreign ministry followed a Christmas Day commentary published by Chinese state media criticizing the Philippines for relying on U.S. support to continually provoke China. The People's Daily claimed Manila's actions were extremely dangerous and harmful. Recent encounters by Chinese and Philippine ships have worsened tensions in the West Philippine Sea. In one incident, China rammed a ship that was taking the Philippine military chief to a Navy outpost in Ayungan Shoal. President Marcos Jr. said that incident was worrisome. He also called for a shift in Manila's approach to its maritime row with Beijing, saying ties between the two countries are heading in a poor direction. 9 Philippine communist rebels are reportedly killed by government troops in the province of Bukidnon. The military launched a Christmas Day offensive after the presence of New People's Army rebels were reported in the hinterlands of the province, of the provincial capital, rather. The encounter occurred despite a unilateral ceasefire declared by the Communist Party of the Philippines. The armed forces dismissed the truce as a mere publicity stunt. Several Philippine policemen and soldiers charged with illegally firing their weapons while celebrating the Christmas holiday. The Philippine National Police says they were involved in 4 incidents of illegal use of their firearms. Their weapons have since been confiscated. A separate case of celebratory gunfire reportedly injured 1 person in Pangasinan Province. Police are trying to locate the suspect.
Ngayong isa naman po ay nangyari po sa San Manuel, Pangasinan. So hindi po nila nakita yung nagpaputok at nakita lang po nila yung mga pasyo po ng mga baril po na ginamit po na parehong caliber 45 po.
Philippine hospitals are gearing up for potential New Year's Eve emergencies as firecracker-related injuries mount. This report. Days before the Philippines officially welcomes 2024, hospitals are busy preparing for the expected deluge of emergency patients who were either injured during the festivities or whose comorbidities may be triggered, either by excessive food, alcohol, or smoke from the firecrackers. The East Avenue Medical Center, a tertiary-level government hospital in Metro Manila's largest city, has begun stockpiling on some supplies.
Kumbaga, routine na sa amin yung mga pag-stockpile ng mga gamit na pangtahe or sutures or pang-address sa mga sugat ng mga pasyente, yung mga anti-tetanus natin, ng mga prophylaxis, antidotes para sa mga na lason for this New Year, yung mga naka-ingest ng mga firecracker.
The hospital has also limited direct admissions and stopped accommodating elective surgeries until January 2.
We usually do special preparations pag palapit na ang New Year. Starting noong December 23, nag-limit muna kami ng mga elective surgeries. So, ibig sabihin, wala kaming tinatanggap na scheduled elective surgery.
The East Avenue Medical Center is one of the hundreds of government hospitals that will be on standby in the next few days, as the New Year celebrations in the Philippines are usually marred by injuries from the use of firecrackers. This year, the Department of Health has renewed its call to urge the public to limit its use of firecrackers and instead welcome 2024 with safer means, such as playing musical instruments, banging pots and cans, or honking vehicle horns. Data from the Department of Health show there were at least 28 cases of firecracker-related injuries as of December 24. Of this number, 94% took place at home or in streets, with a third of the cases happening in the capital region. The health department notes that 7 cases involve the use of legal firecrackers. In a statement, the DOH underscores that fireworks, even when used in designated areas, can still harm even those who were not involved in lighting them. The agency reminds the public that it is better for professionals at community fireworks to do the show, with watchers far away at a safe distance. NERS says, aside from the use of firecrackers, the public should also be mindful of what they consume during the festivities.
As we enjoy this festive season, dapat tandaan natin na mag-celebrate tayo responsibly. Food preparation natin para maiwasan yung mga cases ng food poisoning. Yung mga labis na pagkain at pag-inom, pwede ding may kaakibat yan ng mga sakit. So, huwag po tayong mag-operate ng sasakyan or motor kung nakainom na po tayo.